Yep. All right, well, that definitely happened. Leave a like on this video if Pokemon Go has just drained you of your life, honestly. Just like, not actually asking you guys to leave me a like, but I gotta talk with you all for a second here. I've been heavily addicted. Today was the first day that I've really gone into Pokemon Go since I started yesterday, actually. A few days late to the party, they got stuff going on, projects and everything and things like that. But today was the first day I actually spent like 6 or so hours out of the house with my girlfriend. We were both playing the game, driving around, walking around and stuff. It's so much fun. Like, it's actually, I'm sorry, to those that don't play, it's gonna be a short little rant, but I would imagine that everybody and their mother basically plays this game. It's so crazy, you know what I mean? That we finally have a game that is getting people out of the house. I ran into like 5 people in like the, in like a closed down shopping court at like midnight, basically. Not midnight, like 1 a.m. pretty much. And like 5 people around like one of those like Poke Centers, or whatever the little thing is where you can spin it and get like the Poke Wheels or whatever. I felt like 5 people around then. We talked for a while, and it was just like, it's crazy. You know what I mean? It really is that there is technology now that is getting us out of the house. And mind you, and when I say us, I mean gamers. And mind you, it is still kind of bad that we're glued to our screens, and it is a little bit unsafe. It really is. For the love of God, I hope none of you drive and play the game. I don't. I always pull over whenever I need to do something on there. I never play the game and drive. It's the one rule that I have. But, like, you know, it's just like, it's really cool, you know what I mean? We're getting out of the house now, we're still confined to our phones, but we're not, like, confined to staying in our rooms, which is really nice. I'm actually feeling a lot more fit, too. Been working out a little bit, but this has been, like, awesome. So, welcome back, everybody, to Ark. I'm sorry, a little bit of a Pokemon rant there. I'm debating whether or not I want to film it and post it. I don't really think I'd want to right now. I kind of just want to, like, do it on my own free time, personally. But, for those wondering, like, because I've gotten a few questions, like, you should upload a Pokemon Go series. I'm gonna hold off on it for right now. I think it's gonna chill with Minecraft and Ark for the time being. I've got too much on my plate already. I don't want to throw on a third thing. Anyways, welcome everybody back to another episode of Ark YouTuber Survival Evolved. Today is going to be a pretty interesting day. Also, hype for 50 freaking episodes. We've been doing this stuff for 50 days straight since the start of the series, and I gotta say thank you all so much for your support on this. Honestly, from the moment that not 50 days straight, because when I first, like, uploaded Ark, I, you know, spent a few days. It was like, I didn't upload daily initially, but then once I realized how much you guys loved it, then I started uploading daily, and then I realized how much I loved it. Sorry for my slurring my words, but honestly, guys, I just want to say thank you so much, because when I first started Ark, I thought, this isn't Minecraft. I really, really hope that people are going to enjoy it, and it's been probably the most well-received series that I think I've ever done on my channel. It's been amazing, and I want to say I'm very, very blessed, and, you know, I'm not going to ask for a like rating, not going to ask for any, you know, supports or comments or things like that. I'm just thankful, you know what I mean? Genuinely, if you guys watch this series actively and love the content that I'm making, even if you don't comment, rate, or just interact with the video in any way, you just watch and enjoy every here and there, thank you. Really, just thank you. It's been a huge break, and especially being a Minecraft YouTuber for the longest time, it's a good break that I'm able to play another game aside from Minecraft, which is basically the closest you can get to Minecraft. Ooh, Sabertooth style, not too bad. And just, like, have people love it, you know what I mean? So, thank you guys very much. Anyways, apart from a couple rambles about episode 50 and Pokemon Go, because why fudging not, today we're going to be doing something that's going to be pretty fun, although a bit grindy. So last episode, we got some awesome stuff. We killed an Alpha Raptor and got a Journeyman Metal Hatchet off of a level 11 Alpha Raptor that we man fought, which was awesome. And we also got a lot of hide. How much hide, per se? About 6,900. Let me go ahead and show you guys. So I went ahead and moved the hide over to this building right inside of here, our greenhouse, obviously. Take a look at what we've got here for today. We're going to be building rafts to try and level ourselves up to 85 so we can get a Giga Saddle, finally, and start roaming around with our Giga and killing basically everything except for wild Gigas. This is all the hide that we've got. We go ahead and take off from inventory, 6,934, which is just crazy, absolutely crazy. So I'm gonna go ahead and transfer all that back into there. There we go. Inside of here, we've got some good old fiber. Inside of here, we've got more wood, 4,500? 4,500 wood. In here, we've got another 4,500 wood. In here, we've got another 4,500. In the corner one here, we've got about 3,000. And this one's got about 4,100 wood. Lot of wood. Lot of wood. This one's got a lot more fiber, and this also has a lot more fiber. So, today, we're going to be chaining all of this into about 90 rafts and seeing how much 90 rafts can actually get us in terms of experience. But before we do that, though, Before we do that, we actually need to get prepared to be able to do this here. I'm going to go ahead and look up really fast here what the, hold on, let me see here. Arc Mind Wipe Tonic. Because we're going to need to make another Mind Wipe Tonic today to take our levels and move them into weight and crafting speed. Because if we didn't have that, this is going to be a lot more painful than it needs to be. So to do that, we need 24 cooked prime meat, which we have a ton of. 200 Mesa Berries, we got a lot of those guys. 72 Narcotics, easy game. 72 Stimulants, though, I think is the only thing we actually need to make right now. We got a good old level up for our female Impossum Bear. I did go through the comments on the episode where we did get our baby, and I haven't read through all of them quite yet. I will in a little while, probably after we're done by the end of this episode here. But I do know a couple of people did have some good idea with these names. Everybody wanted me to color this bear purple. For what reason, I'm not exactly sure. But I think we're going to go ahead and do that then. We'll spray paint this one purple, but that'll be after the episode is done. So in the meanwhile then, what do we have to do to learn up? I think it's over here. Yes, okay. So we got to learn stimulants. And to be able to make a stimulant, what do I need again? It's stim berries, right? Drug stimulant is 2 spark powder and 5 stim berries. So we need spark powder. To be able to get that, we have a stone though. Do we have any more spark powder on the side here? No, we don't. We need flint. That's what I thought. Okay. So what we need to do now is we need to get a little bit of flint, and then we need to make that into the stimulants, and then we need to gather up everything else. I actually have a little bit of spare hide over here. I'm gonna grab that just for right now. Probably shouldn't be, so I should keep some in here on my own. But I'm just gonna take it for the time being. I think, okay, what we're gonna go and do then is get a little bit of flints. We're gonna get the stimulants. We're gonna get everything that we need. Catch you guys back when we mind wipe tonic up. And, this should be pretty fun. This is honestly my favorite thing, okay? You got the ruins over here, which got added a while ago. You have a pretty decently looking, archway over here. And then you got, like, what seems to be a broken down wall. A couple little scraps on the ground. Doesn't really matter what they are. Everything looks pretty normal, right? And then you just got this thing. You just got this thing that just looks like a chicken wing. It honestly looks like, look at my inventory, the number one slot. It kind of looks like cooked meat. That looks like cooked meat right then. That's great. That's sweet. Okay, so we got our stimulants over there. That's number one in check. Okay, we got to do it in here. Oh, and forgot we had stuff in here. Forgot we still had stuff in here. Gotta remember that I've made this before. So we still have a rare mushroom. So we got those. The stimulants, we've already got a few of them. We're gonna drop that in there. That's fine. Got the narcotics, so that's good. Those guys are good to go. Mijo berries, we got 200 of those. And then the only thing that we need right then is we need to go ahead and get a little bit of water for this guy right over here. And then we also need the 24 cooked prime meat, which I should have. There's the 24. Perfect. And we'll go ahead and, I guess, go down right here. I really need to, I really want to get an industrial cooker so I can wind up just bringing in the water without having to do any water jar stuff. But, like, I don't know. It doesn't seem the most valuable to me. What I really want to spend my metal on is the industrial forge. That's going to be so freaking good. Once we get the industrial forge, I promise you guys, the metal runs are just going to pop off. I promise you. Because the only thing that I hate about metal runs is how much... Are we good? They were good. All right. The only thing I hate about metal runs is how much freaking time it takes to smelt up all of the metal, as well as the charcoal it's made and the fact that I have to get wood. The second I can start using gasoline, oh, I'm going to be so overbeared. But anyways, this guy's cooking up our Mind Wipe Tonic right now, and then we'll be good to go. And then, of course, we have our Bross of Enlightenment that we'll be using as well. I am curious of what we're going to be putting our Ingrams into when it comes down to weight and crafting speed. Because I would feel that weight is the most important, crafting speed kind of being important. But I think weight would be mostly due to the fact that you'd just be able to carry more. I don't know. That's what I think personally. I think we're going to invest as much as we can into crafting, or weight rather, and then put the rest into crafting speed afterward. But, we'll make sure I've got everything to be able to make this. We're making this fine, right? Good prime meat, that's good. Mijo berries, we're fine by that. Narcotics, fine. Stimulants, fine. Rare mushroom and rare flower. Yeah, everything's good. We got our water jar. There it is. Okay, cool. Mind Wipe Tonic expires in 10 hours. And, I guess we are a little bit encumbered right now. What are we encumbered by? We're encumbered by quite a bit right now, aren't we? Yeah, we got a little bit of weight on us. All right, I guess no better time than right now to just go ahead and fire the sucker up right now. Do I have any food that I can possibly borrow? Yes, I do. Thank you very much. Shout out on a little bit of that. Okay, Mind Wipe Tonic being activated. 3, 2, 1. Ooh, there it all goes. And we're fully encumbered and back down to level 1. Just how are we going to be able to get that saddle now? It seems like we're so far away. Okay. Wait then. We're at 100. Everything's back to normal. This is going to be temporary. Remember, we're just doing it for today. I guess we'll go ahead and level this guy up as much as we can. I want to see how much we can go. Maybe let's do 500, I think, for... Nah, that's still... I don't know. 500 is still impressive. Let's do 600. 600? 600, that's good. That's good. And then the rest into crafting speed, I think. 600 is really good. Like, that's really good. Crafting speed, how much? Ooh, it goes up by 10s as well. Okay. So if we wanted to, 300% crafting speed, maybe 600 and 400? That's what I'm thinking. Or maybe 700 weight. Because a lot of weight is really good for being able to move, maneuver around, which I feel would be less annoying. Let's, I think, do the weight. I think we're going to go ahead and do the weight. We'll go ahead and do the weight back up all the way to 710. There we go, baby. And we are... There we go. Oh my god, look at how slow we move. We're not even encumbered. This is how slow you move before I set all my levels into movement speed. God damn, that's slow as hell, man. I also got to remember, too, that I cannot, and I repeat, cannot jump off my roof. Otherwise, I will die. I will straight up die if I fall off my roof because of the low life that I've got right now with only 100. I think it takes away 125 of my health if I fall off my roof all the way down to the ground. So I don't want to do that. Okay, either way. Powered, where is? There you are. Got our Broth of Enlightenment. We're only going to be rocking one today, and it's going to spoil in 51 minutes. That should be okay. I think we'll only need one. Should be able to rock out all these rafts in 20 minutes, I would say. At least I hope so. I hope so, at least. Okay, let's go ahead and gather over here. This is going to be kind of interesting. Hopefully, it'll be relatively entertaining. I know it might really not be, but let's just hope anyway. Yeah, that little drop right over there just degraded a third of my health. Jesus Christ. Okay, blank space, do you have anything inside of you? You got a lot of berries. You got a little bit of thatch. Nothing of value. So, again, this is our little corner right now. This is what we're working on. So, to be able to work... Oh, we have to learn a raft. Okay, so to be able to work with this, we just need a wooden raft. All right. So we need 250 wood for it, 125 hyber, and 75 hide. Obviously, the wood being the most valuable of the source. So go ahead and gather out. Let's just take about maybe... The hide really, like, it weighs nothing. You know what I mean? I can just take a bunch of hide on me and I'm fine. Same with the fiber. Like, same with the fibers is fine. It's honestly mostly the wood. Yeah, I can just take, like... Honestly, I can take just most of not, if not all... Yeah, I can just take all the hide and all the fiber that I've got out right now and just pop it into my inventory. Yeah, there you go. And I'm encumbered by 300 at the moment. And I can just put the rest into the wood that I've got. Oh, hell yeah. No, yeah, we're definitely going to do it that way, I think. All right, cool. So, we'll just pop as much wood as we can right now. Just as much as we can. Should be able to get about 1,400. Oh, my God. We're carrying 1,400 worth of items right now, which is nuts. So we can make a total of 8 rafts right now, which is all just because of our lack of wood. All right. Yeah, let's just crush this out. Broth of Enlightenment going down. 3, 2, 1. There's the XP boost, and let's get these guys crafting. So we're currently right now at level 82. The speed for them is not too bad, and that jumps you up a pretty fair distance right there. Let's see how many it takes to get... From 82 to 83. Now, I don't think we're going to hit 85 doing this right now. I don't think that we will. But I do just want to see. And am I able to access the inventories? Yes, indeed, I am. Okay, cool. Very, very cool. So, we're just going to go ahead and transfer these guys as we do it right along here. So, we've done about... We can actually carry the CB up by the amount of rafts that we got here. So, that's 6 rafts. We might actually be able to cap it out using only 8. 7. And then I think the 8th one's going to go and do it. Come on, baby. Come on. Come on. You going to get it for me? There you go. Sick. And then we're going to go ahead and put the remainder into weight by just a little bit right there. And then I think what we're going to do is drop all the rafts that we make into just our chest so we can work with them a little bit better. There we go. Ooh, we don't want to stop doing these guys. We want to make sure we can get as many as we can. All right, get all that. Wow, our wood is going by so fast. It's insanity. All this work that I did to get all the wood over here, it's just gone. It's just being, I'm just watching it leave me in the matter of seconds. And it's disgusting. Alright, so I got a bunch of wood on us from right over there. I don't want to, like, do all this just on camera right now, but I feel like I want to do an entire level for you guys, just because I want to see how much it's going to take. I mean, right now with the Broth of Enlightenment, we're doing really, really good right now. I'm kind of a little bit salty that we weren't able to do this around the time that cakes were relevant on the server, but I know for a fact that at that time, cakes didn't stack with broth, so it didn't really make a difference at all. Alright, Rafts, and we are good. What keeps dropping? Oh, it's because I'm shitting myself. I'm like, what keeps dropping on the floor? Nope, just defecating myself. We're okay. All right, our weight is still at 1440. We're at 1440p right now. That's crazy. When your weight is like a monitor you're playing on. Heart eye emoji. All right, more of these guys going out. Definitely a little bit more of a chill time right now. Definitely a little bit more of a chill time. What should we talk about? Pokemon Go, possibly? I don't know. This is like the test of time. Do you enjoy me? Or do you enjoy my art content? Because I feel like if you just enjoy my art contents, you might not be watching anymore. So, there's that, you know what I mean? Anyways, regardless though, how are we doing on levels? We're actually already halfway through right now, and we've made a total of... I don't actually know how many... Oh my god, this is actually kind of really hype. How many rafts have we made right now? I'm not able to tell. Hold on, we've made 20... Nearly 30 rafts, and we're actually getting through this really fast. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I'm feeling pretty good. I'm feeling pretty good about the amount of the level progression we're gonna be able to get on this. Again, I would like to go out and get more wood to be able to make more of them, but it's not the wood. It's definitely the fact that the rafts are taking up, the hide, rather, is the main complication. And I got a couple people last episode being like, why didn't you just take your Giga out to get the hide? Because those guys gather up a ton of hide, if you guys don't know. Like, Gigas are huge to get hide. The reason why I didn't is because I'm not going to take my Giga out until I get a saddle on it. Because, for example, I did actually run into a wild Giga. And, let's just say, if you guys don't actually know, a wild Giga can kick the crud out of a tame Giga. Because tame Gigas are so much weaker. For example, the Giga that I got had about 88,000 experience. I want to make sure I'm recording right now. Am I recording? I am? Okay, good. Thank God. The Giga that I had initially, that I tamed, had, I think, 88,000 health when it was wild. And now it only has 22,000. So, they're definitely nerfed quite a bit. As well as the attack damage is halved. So, it's really, really weak. So, if you ever run into, like, a wild Giga with a normal tame Giga, your tame Giga is gonna die, unfortunately. As much as you wish it wasn't the case. Maybe a saddle could have protected a bit more, but I'm pretty sure a wild Giga would still kick its ass. Either way, though... We're actually just about to level up to level 84 right now, which is really impressive. That's really good, actually. That's really, really good. Yeah, that's awesome. Our Broth of Enlightenment is still lasting us a frick ton of time right now. Yeah, that's... Wow. That's incredible. Yeah, there you go. There's another level right then. Still cannot move because we do not have any ability to run. Put a little bit more into weight right then. And we're done on rafts right now. We can go ahead and put the remaining rafts away. There we go. And I think we have right over here our last wood chest, I believe. Yeah, we got our last chest of wood. And we've gone all the way up to level... Ooh. Wait a second. What am I lacking? I'm lacking fiber. All things that I have more. Okay, I was like, wait a minute, hold on. There's no way that I chewed through all the fiber that I had before, right? We didn't. Okay, we're good. I was like, wait a second. I'm not out of... I thought I was out of hide for a second. And if I was out of hide, then I would have cried. Because I would have lied to you guys and... I don't know. I'm going to shut up right now. Anyways, we're doing actually pretty good. This level might actually take a while to get to right now. We're level 85, right? We're 84. Yeah, we're level 84 right now. This is a really easy way to level up. This really is. This is incredibly easy, dude. I mean, granted, again, you guys have to remember, the amount of grinding I did off camera was very significant. To get the hide, the wood was nothing. I mean, it did take a while on beavers, like maybe 10, 12 trips back into the forest, but the hide was definitely the most painful part, I would say. But now that we have our hatchets, like, it's a lot easier, too. Anyway, craft a few more of these guys right over here. We're getting really close. We're actually getting really close. I think we're going to be able to crush out two solid levels by the time we're done with this. Because we were about, like, right here. We were about, like, right here by the time that we started, I think. I think so. I think about that, yeah, if I can remember correctly. So, let me go ahead and dish that out there. If anything, in all honesty, I might try and... I don't know. I got to figure out what to do with my Broth of Enlightenment while I still have it. And then, ooh, that's actually all the wood. That's all the wood we got. That is all of the wood that we have to our name. That's all the wood that we got to our name. I don't know about the hide, but I know it's all the wood that we have to our name. No, we still got quite a bit of hide, actually. So you know what I might do, in all honesty? Is we're still rocking this, and that's the last one that we can afford with the amount of wood that we've got. Alright. All of our wood is gone. That's the final bits of that. We're gonna go ahead, I think, now and get on blank space. Let's go ahead and crush out. Hold on. Let me go ahead and get on this guy. Drop all items. Let's go ahead and try, because we've got still 800 seconds left of our Broth of Enlightenment. We might as well try getting as much wood as we can really take advantage of the amount of hide that we've got. So at the moment, what's our hide count? Our hide count is really good, actually. Really, really good. Yeah. If we get wood right now, we may actually be able to get, like, dangerously close to a level 85. And then we can maybe finish off our level by maybe killing an alpha or something, if you think about it. I don't really know. Like, the thing is, too, is I could also kill this parasaur here and get a little bit of experience. Not experience, but, like, take the hide from this guy. Because right there, what is that? Like, 61 hide. It's pretty, it's a fair amount. Not really all that much. Anyways, let's go ahead and crush out some trees right now. You get an obscene amount of wood from these guys. It's crazy. And the thing is, too, is that the amount of wood these guys could carry is nothing. Or everything, rather. Because it only oh, hold on. Did we close that gate? Yeah, we did. Alright, who are you? You are a little, oh, you're a little Oviraptor. We need to tame an Oviraptor. I don't really know if it'd be worth it all that much. Because I know they're used for, taming or getting more eggs, I believe. And I think you have to use Quetzal Kibble on them. I think so. Either that or Giga Kibble. I think it might actually be Giga. Nah, I don't think so. Maybe? It might actually be. It might actually be. Anyway, so we're going to transfer all the wood that we possibly can right now. Take off from inventory. There we take. We took all of it. Holy crud. We can go ahead and make 8 more rafts just right now. Yo. Hell yes. Let's actually see. So we're at the P right now. How much do we jump up with the 8 that we're making right now? So from P to O. From O to about I. So we're probably going to get to like right about here, I'd say. I'm going to bet right here where my mouse is. This is going to be my bet. Ooh, I don't know. I don't want to move it too much. Right there. Right there with the 4 that we've got. I want to see if it's going to count. Maybe. Might actually get pretty close. Come on. This is exhilarating content. This is exhilarating. You guys thought that episode 85 was going to be like some blow your mind out of the water craziness. We're also not going to get that close by far. You thought it was going to be madness. Blowing just, it's just, it would just be insane. Hell no, dude. Hell no. We're building rafts today. If anything, I'm being honest though, you guys might have had this spoiled by the title of the video, depending on what we do, but I would really, really love to spend today getting the Giga Saddle and riding around my Giga for episode 50, because that, I think, personally, would be insane to be able to do. I feel like, nah, you know what? That wasn't a goal before for this episode, because I didn't think I was going to get nearly this close, but we are definitely setting that as our goal. We're getting a Giga Saddle today. Doesn't matter how many resources we're going to need for it, and we're going to ride that sucker around and kill some shit. Oh, this is actually awesome right here. Check us out. My pike is about to break right now, but we got a couple of these guys running around. They're going to get stuck behind here. This is going to be a good amount of hide for me, as well as meat. Actually, mostly hide. There we go. And the Mega Nero is now coming after me. Come on, Mega Nero, let's go. Let's go, bitch. Let's go, bitch. There you go. You're fine. And then we got this guy. I think the other one actually ran away. Pretty sure he did. Anyway, so... ooh, why are we blood red just then? A little bit strange. Okay. Ooh, actually, hold on. Okay, so we have some wood left on this guy. We're getting really close. Like, we're actually very, very close to being able to consider us level 85. Like, look at our leveling right now. We've gone up two solid levels right now doing this. And I think, actually, we might be able to get to level 85 without using our Broth of Enlightenment over again. We still got about maybe 8 minutes or so on the clock right now, which should be enough. If anything, we just don't want to lose our amount of hide. We're actually doing pretty good on hide. We're actually doing really good on it. How much does it take? Only takes 75 hide. So we can make quite a few more of these guys with the amount of hide that we got here, but it's definitely going to be worth it to kill more. We're just on the cusp of it, though. I actually did not think I was going to get anywhere close to this amount of experience. Because I saw, what was it, Lachlan do it before, I think, and Choco as well. I saw both of them do it. And I saw them get, like, I think Lachlan got, like, maybe a level and a bit. And I think Choco grinded out for a long time, and he got a couple levels, I'm pretty sure. But I did not, I thought I was going to get more of, like, you know, toward Lachlan's end. Because I didn't think that I grinded that much. And I really didn't, you know what I mean? I got a lot of wood, to be fair. But I think it was the amount of time that I spent getting the hide that really made the biggest difference here. Also, we really need to toss the amount of berries on this guy. We'll do it in a little bit here. Let me just go ahead and get inside this dude right here. Come on, man. Come on, you're going to get me to it. You're going to get me to it. How much do we got here? We can make 5 more. Beautiful. Craft those all up. Come on, faster. Don't lag on me, server. Not right now. Not right now. Five. Let's see how much five gets us. Ooh, we're so close. We might actually be able to do it with the amount of hide. I don't know, though. Ooh, our hide count's running low. It's definitely running low, but I think we've got just enough, actually. Because the problem is, this is all the hide that we have to our name. We took out the... Ooh, you know what, actually? This is the hide that we took out from our smithy that I said that I shouldn't. But I did anyway, thinking that I might need it. And yeah, we definitely needed it right now. We're actually... You know what, guys? Yeah. Guarantee you in a second here. This is amazing. Because I believe in just a moment, we are about to get level 85 and unlock some seriously sick shit that you have never before laid your eyes on. Because 85 is monumental. Not just for a Giga Saddle, but for some other seriously, seriously cool stuff. So let me go ahead and get that around there. Just keep going until this dude's encumbered. Keep it going, keep it going. We got 376 seconds left. More than enough time right now. All right, you're fully encumbered. Let's go and toss all that wood from you, dude. All right, take all from inventory. Craftables, we can make only one because we have a lack of fiber. Oh, dear. It's not what I expected at all. This is not good. Okay, here's what we gotta do. Drop item. And now what we gotta do is we gotta transfer... Hold on a second. Wait, no. Okay. We gotta transfer all the wood. We're gonna have this guy drop all his items, and then we're gonna transfer all these items into him. So now I believe we should be able to continue moving. We gotta get back home. We gotta get the fiber that's still in our chest. We still got a bit of fiber. A lot of fiber, actually. A full chest full, I'm pretty sure. Alright, come on, baby. We got about 4 minutes left of this Broad of Enlightenment over here. Let's suck it all up. Got all that fiber on us, baby. That's beautiful. That's what I love to see. And then we'll take all that wood out from there. Perfect. We make six more of them. Guys, I think right now, let's see it. Let's see it happen. This is the big moment. This is the big episode 50 moment. This is the episode 50 moment, baby. Right then, let me see it happen. That's what I'm talking about. Mmm. It feels good. It feels freaking... Oh, it feels so good. It just feels so nice. So nice. It feels so nice. Anyways, we are now level 85. Let me put that straight back into weight right then. Holy hot damn. And we are still fully encumbered. We got another about 3 minutes of our Broth of Enlightenment. Don't even care. We're done with the game. And at the end of it, we have 145 hide to spare. Can you talk about having a good amount? I think we definitely planned that. You know what? I'm proud of me. I would say us, but it was me, so I'm sorry. I'm proud of myself. You know what? I really calculated this good. Even if just like being pretty basic, just like being, oh, I can make 90. I had no idea what 90 was going to get me. I genuinely had no idea. And we had just enough to get us basically right to there. So, guys, let's take a look at what we can now make at level 80. I gotta check again. Am I recording? I am recording. Mic is going off. If anything's wrong, I'm sorry. I can't repeat this. What do we got for 85? Let's see what we got over here. Okay, and all the way down. So we have, from the start then, what do we have here? Riot gear that we already had. Oh, here we go. Okay, so the industrial forge. Refines resources in bulk, powered by gasoline. This is the biggest one, in my opinion. The minigun turret, this is pretty alright. We don't really need it because we're not a PvP server. A Mosasaur platform saddle is insanity. Of course, the Giga Saddle. Why not? The chemistry bench, which, this is insane, okay? Because the chemistry bench is actually the upgraded version of the mortar and pestle. Which I'm sure you guys know is a small little... Yeah, you know what it is. It's kind of funny. I was talking to Choco about this. It's really weird how, you know, you get like... You have the industrial forge, you know what I mean? Actually, I should say... I don't know. It's just weird how you get the upgraded version of the mortar and pestle so late into the game when it's one of the earliest things you can learn being a mortar and pestle. The big thing about this is that it actually gives you more resources per your thing. So this is going to be big for us for gunpowder. That's going to be insane. To be able to make this, though, you need absorbent substrate, which is, actually, I think so? No, wait, no. You have to craft this at the chemistry bench. And to be able to, and then from that, you make the gas mask, which is 110 Ingrams. That's just insane. Protects the wearer against various airborne poisons. We definitely need that for sure. Yeah, we definitely need that for sure. At least I think so. Pretty sure you use that with the chemistry bench. At least I think. Anyways, a lot of stuff has gone down for us. That's insane. So what I'm going to go ahead and do right now is, as great as these levels are in weight and, you know, crafting speed, We need to go ahead and bring him all the way back to what we had before. So I'm going to go ahead and make another wine white tonic, and I'll catch you guys back in a moment when we redistribute all our levels. Okay, so we got our last bit of stuff right over here. The only thing that we need is the cooked prime meat, which I don't actually think that I have inside of here. I've got 22 on me, and that would be about it. Now, thankfully, yesterday, we went on a really big hunting spree. Also, I gotta remember that my health is very minimal. Brandon, please don't do that again. We got a lot of cooked prime meat inside of here, so we're looking pretty okay in that department. Everything's good. Now, I will say one thing. I did have a lot of time, obviously, with, you know, my first time using the Mind Wipe Tonic properly to, really, oh, what do we need now? Oh, right, we need something to light it. Okay, there we go, and we are good. So I had some time to really think about, like, what I really enjoyed about what I did before with the whole Mind Wipe reset with the stats and stuff. Movement speed, oh, best decision that I've ever made in my fudging life. However, the one thing that I really did not like that I did was I took everything out of melee damage and did not up any of it, with the assumption of, like, or the justification rather of, if I'm gonna be fighting stuff that I need to kill like that, I'll just be shooting it, you know what I mean? But no, you really should never think like that. Melee damage is pretty important in my opinion, so that's like, ideally, we should be putting a lot of our levels toward melee damage, especially even more so than movement speed. Although, I have seen that, like, if you put all your levels into movement speed and you're a level 96, you can literally outrun an Alpha Raptor. You're so fast. It's insanity. I tested it on a single player world just for, like, shits and giggles. You guys know that I have a single player world that I just use for, like, cheating and stuff or screenshots and things like that. I don't use it to spoil anything. There it is, my White Sonic. But, yeah, it's fun. It's really, really fun to just kind of, like, mess around there, and, you can go really fast. Anyway, so, we're gonna go ahead and by the way, I hardly ever go on it, so don't worry. It's not like I'm, like, I don't know what you guys would assume, but no, I barely go on it. I've spent maybe 10 minutes on the server in its lifetime. So, yeah, it's hardly anything. But anyways, Mind Wipe Tonic going out. 3, 2, 1. There we go. So, we now have 85 levels to work with our stuff. So, we're gonna go ahead and do the basics. 200 health, 250 health, 250 health for right then, that's good. Weight we can go ahead and put into, I would say 200 for right now. It's low, it's very low, but we're gonna put it just 200 for the time. Nah, okay, that's excessive. 250 should be fine. Now what I wanna see here, melee damage goes up by 5%, whereas movement speed only goes up by 2%. So that's the thing. So what I might want to do, actually, is try getting my melee damage up to 200%, actually. I'm gonna do that. Yeah, 200% melee damage. My god. My god, that's impressive. That's insanity. Now that I think about it, that's really insane. So now, what do we want to do then? What I'm thinking, this is gonna be like our killing floor, right? Like our ability to kill things. So I'm thinking, this is what I've got an idea for. 300 health, since having 250 really didn't feel all that great, if I'm being honest. 300 weight. Movement speed, What are we gonna have left? Because I feel like I love the melee damage where it's at right now at 200%, but I also feel like you could use a little bit more. Let's just see what I could get with putting the rest, because fortitude is also, fortitude is also nice. We're gonna do 10 fortitude. And we're going to do the rest in the melee movement speed. I think I'm just going to put it up to 76. What did that put us at? 120% movement speed? Yeah, I think maybe a little bit more fortitude, because we're tying right around that then. A little bit more fortitude maybe, I feel. I'm not sure. Just like preventing getting knocked out. I don't know. But we could always use berries to get rid of the ability to have us knocked out. So it's not really all that viable. Movement speed, however, is pretty viable. I'm just going to put the rest in the movement speed. Yeah, okay, there we go. So, what are we at right now? 300 health, which is beautiful. Same stamina, same oxygen, same food, same water. Weight is 300, that's pretty good. Melee damage is 200 freaking percent, which, to put it in perspective, obviously, means we could have killed that Alpha Raptor yesterday in half the time. So, that says something. Move speed is 138%. We're slower than before. Let's go ahead and see by how much, how fast we move right now. I mean, okay, we're not as blazing fast as before, but we're still pretty fast, I'd say. Like, this is respectable, you know what I mean? It's not ridiculous like before, but I think the strength that we now have in our buffer is just so much more worth it, in my opinion. And we're still... when you're trying to poop out that egg, but just, it just doesn't, you can't. Call life alert. They can help you. So guys, I think the final thing that we gotta do for the episode 50 special today is, we gotta see what it's gonna take to make a Giga Saddle. And I'm not really looking forward to this, because I have a feeling it's gonna be a lot of pain and a lot of misery and a lot of suffering of time that I could spend playing Pokemon Go instead. So I'm a little bit nervous right now, but let's see. We got a total of 2,234 anger points to learn up right now. Giga Saddle. There it is. So to be able to craft this guy, what do we need? That's not bad at all, actually. 120 metal ingots, that's easy mode. Wow, actually, hold on a second. Wait a minute. That's really easy. We have the metal and we have the fiber. All we need is the hide. Which, granted, we don't have a lot of because we kind of need to use it all. In fact, we actually need to go out and get 680 hide. Okay, so we have the metal, we have the fiber, and we have the hide. All we need to do is go out and get a little bit of, we have the metal, we have the fiber. We just need to go out and get hide. So, hell yeah, dude, let's do it. The moment of truth is finally here, what we've been waiting on for so long. Also, I just realized that I have so much prime meat on me. Holy fudge, get it over. Oh, it's gonna all spoil. It's gonna all spoil. I think it's all gonna spoil. Pretty sure it will. Oh god, except turn on. Is it gonna spoil? Actually, it may not. Oh, I hope we can somehow save this, because I know we use a lot of prime meat today. I didn't actually think that I got that much prime meat from today, but I guess I did. Holy damn. Can we have this cook here? I'm gonna wait for it. I want to see it. Is it gonna cook? I think it might actually all be able to cook. If it does it in 20-second intervals, which I think that it does. Will it? Oh, yeah. No, that's sweet. Okay, cool. So we can actually get ourselves that. But the more important thing for today, guys, here we go. Let's toss in all the hide that we got here. 1, 2, 3, 4... and 5 and 6. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Craft it up, baby. Equip a Giganotosaurus with this to ride it. Holy damn, what is about to even happen? This is insane. Okay. It's primitive Giga Saddle. Fully encumbered. Oh, yes, I am. You better believe it. Transfer that item right there. Is there anything I can get rid of? I guess we have a lot of raw meat that we really don't need, I guess. Raw meat. Yeah, how much raw meat? We got so many. I'm gonna go and drop all the raw meat, because that is literally... Actually, no, thinking about it, to be fair, I don't really need the raw meat for anything, but if there is something I could use it for, I guess it'd be to refill some of the feeding troughs. And let me go ahead and, grab out the, cooked meat. 17 cooked prime meat from that. Really, really good. I mean, cooked prime meat, to be fair, though, is very easy for us to get at this stage. Can't really ride with any of those guys. I guess we can ride with Riptooth. Alright, dude, let's go. Day has finally come. Let's do it. Giga, get over here, my man. Come on, see if you can run through all those guys in front of you. I know they're your biggest fans, but just see if you can bring yourself a little bit more forward toward me, why don't you, okay? Oh my god. Holy shit. Alright, my man. How you doing? Let's go ahead and pop you on right then. Got him on the saddle. Let's go ahead and pop on that melee damage. 63.4%. There's the saddle. And... yep. Here we are. Riding a freaking Giga. What even is progression? What even is progression? I don't even know what it is at this point. So to my knowledge, these guys will only get enraged if you deal them 25% or more damage. And I also learned if you jump it off of a cliff, then basically, if it's ever falling off a cliff for whatever reason, dismount from it immediately, because then it won't take any fall damage, because dinos that aren't riding don't take fall damage. So yeah, that's something we gotta really remember in case of any emergencies, is just sacrifice our own life, which is why I made it apparent that we have our, what's it called, the parachute on us. But yeah, furthermore... oh my god. And look at that hide count. These guys are the prime for getting hide. And he's already leveling up. Is he already leveling up? Yeah. Oh my god. Raw prime. Oh my god, the prime meat. The prime meat from the Stegos is insane. The Primeape from Masego is actually insane. Now, the only thing with these guys is that they do have trouble getting through rocks, I believe. And the unfortunate thing with these guys, too, is that while the Primeape will be immense of what you can get from these guys, there's really nothing you can do with it because there's no such thing as a platform saddle for a Giga. So, you can't really cook it. Also, the stamina on these guys goes down immensely fast. He's already out of stamina. Wow. This guy's already out of stamina that fast. You're kidding me, right? Jesus, this dude eats through stamina. Really, then? Does he lose a lot of stamina while just walking? No, he doesn't. But running drains the stamina like mad. So I guess we can't really run with this guy. That's okay, I guess. All I know is that I've heard from a lot of people, or like a lot of forums and stuff, 16 raw... Oh, you know what? Actually, I think this guy is probably the best way to get raw prime meat. Yeah, it looks like it. 16 raw prime meat from that. I heard from a lot of people that, like, gigas aren't worth it. They aren't that valuable to get. In all honesty, the reason that these guys are valuable in my mind is the amount of hide you can get from them. It's nuts. You can get more from this than you can from my metal hatchet by, like, 2 times pretty much. And you can step on dodos. You can literally just step on dodos. I didn't even click anything. Like, where's the dodo? Where's the dodo? There's a dodo. No, wait, is that a list? It's a list. Is that gonna kill him? Please don't kill him. No, I didn't kill him. Okay, thank God. But if there's a dodo around here, which I think there was. Where's the dodo? I don't know where the dodos are. I can't even tell. Wait, is this a bronzo? Hold on a second. Is this a bronzo right here? It is. Level 11 female bronzo. I want to see what happens. Hold on. Ready for it? Dodos are dead. Shrike's dead. What about the bronzo? And the bronzo is dead. How much hide do we get from it? 200 hide. And this dude took no HP damage. He's already got a level up. I mean, like, it's ridiculous. This dude is so much fun. I was honestly skeptical. I'm like, is he going to be fun? And is he going to have a good use to him? And oh, the answer is so much of both. So much of both. And with 25,000 health, like, there's no complaining at all. But yeah, guys, I think we're going to go ahead and end it off right here. Today was a very successful day. Very, very successful day. The amount of meat that you can grab from this guy. And he carries 742 weight. As well as, I believe, meat. Nah, meat, it also weighs the same. Okay, cool. But yeah, this dude, like... it's mental. So anyways, guys... leave a like for episode 50. Leave a like for just a monumental occasion. And I love you all very much. Thank you guys for a massive amount of support through 50 very, very strong and entertaining episodes. In my mind, I feel like I've done a pretty good job. Now, granted, there's some guys, you know, like, I know there's a lot of other ARK YouTubers out there that do ARK so much better than I do, taking a lot more seriously, a lot more time. And you know what? Good off to them. And I may be a noob, I'm still definitely a noob at ARK. But you know what? I think that I'm doing pretty good so far myself. For being a noob, I think I'm like a solid 3 out of 10. Love you guys very much. Take care. I will catch you all back tomorrow for another episode. And yeah, I'm going to go ahead and go do a very frantic edit to make sure none of this ever gets lost. So yeah, catch you guys around. Take care. And I'll see you back tomorrow. Ciao!